Welcome guys, this is 27th question of NET December 2018 and it's a question from part B. So let us read the question. Consider the subspace W1 and W2 of R cube. So we have two subspaces W1 and W2 given by this. So this is W1 and this is W2. So they are saying that if W is a subspace of R cube such that W intersection W2, okay, so W intersection W2 is basically the span of 0, 1, 1, okay. So, in order for the word span, I am using, okay, instead of this word span, I will use this notation, okay. So, you see, your W is actually a span of this vector. 0, 1, 1. Okay, so your W is the span of this vector. So, W intersection W2 is a span of this vector. And second one, the second condition on W is that W intersection W1 is orthogonal to W intersection W2 with respect to the usual inner product. Okay, so they are saying that they are orthogonal with respect to the usual inner product. Okay, so in order to solve this question, you must know what is actually an inner product. You can look on in any book the definition of inner product, what it is, and for the sake of convenience, you can say that in the system R cube, or we can say real system, the inner product, the usual inner product, is actually a dot product. Okay, so suppose that you have R cube, then you are getting two vectors in R cube. So suppose that this one is your is your first vector, and this one a1 b1 c1, and this one is your second vector. Okay, so let us say this is A, this is B. Then what will be the inner product? Inner product is generally denoted as this. So inner product of A and B is actually a dot product. Okay, that you know already. So this is the usual inner product. Okay, so it's a usual inner product on R cube. Okay, so I have written in the form of IJK, that because you can just relate it to your 12th class definition of vectors. That's why I have written it like this. Okay, now come back to the question. What they are saying, that your W satisfies this condition number one and condition number two. Then you have to find out which one of these four is your W. Okay, so first of all, I will just explicitly write down what is your W1. Okay, so in the W1, you see you are getting this as your equation. Okay, x plus y plus z is equal to 0. So that means any vector that belong to W1 should have x coordinate plus y coordinate plus z coordinate equal to 0. Okay, so by this equation I can write z as minus x minus y. So you can write your W as, not W, W1 as x y comma minus x minus y. Okay, because your z is already dependent on your x and y by this equation, and x comma y belongs to R. So you see, you have actually two free variable in this case, x and y are independent variable, they are not dependent, but your z is dependent. So your W1 is a subspace such that its dimension is actually 2. So the dimension of W1 is 2. So just put x is equal to 1. Okay, I will write 2 li vector. Okay, since W1 has dimension 2, so its basis must contain 2 li vector. Okay, so I am just writing those 2 li vector. So in order to get those 2 li vector, just put x as 1 and y as 0. What you will get? You will get this one as your first li vector, and in the sec, for getting second, you just put x as 0 and y as 1. You will get this as your li vector. Now your W1 is actually generated by these two vectors. Okay, so you can write it in the form of this. So your W1 is generated by this. Now for the W2, you have a restriction that your x minus y plus z should be 0. That again means that your z is actually dependent on these two variables. So you can write your W2 as x comma y comma minus x plus y, where x comma y belongs to R. Now you see here that you get two independent variables. That means dimension of W2 is also 2. So its basis must contain two Li vector. So in order to get those two Li vector, again put x as 1. So what you are getting, and y as 0, you will get this one. And if you put x as 0 and y as 1, you will get this. So your W2 is generated by this. Okay, so I will erase everything. You understand how to get the generating vector? Okay, so it's very easy to get generating vector like this. Okay, so I will erase and I will write this separately here. So your W1 is generated by 1 0 minus 1 and 0 1 minus 1. Okay, and your W2, so this is your W2. Your W2 is generated by 1 0 minus 1 and 0 1 1. So these are the two vectors that is generating W1 and W2. Okay, now W1 is generated by this and W2 is generated by this. Okay, now we come back to the question. What they are saying, that W is a subspace that satisfies the condition number 1, that W is something whose intersection with W2 is going to be a span of 0, 1, 1. Okay, so you have to make choice for W. Suppose you have basically 4 options, W, W, W and W. You have 4 options. So if you take this as your answer, okay, so if you take your answer W as this, so suppose this is your W, then you will see that its intersection, okay, its intersection with W2 must be a span of this. So this, if you are choosing as your W, then your intersection with W2, okay, what you are getting, your intersection with W2 is, okay, I will write it here. If you are choosing B as your answer, what you will get if you are choosing W as a span of this? Okay, so you see W intersection W2 is what? From this and this, you will get W intersection W2 is a span of 1, 0, minus 1, because that's a common vector between them. Okay, so it will be a span of 1, 0, minus 1, but that is incorrect, because you have to get 0, you need 0, 1, 1, okay, W intersection W2 as a span of 0, 1, 1. But from this, you are getting that W intersection W2 is actually a span of this, so B option is actually false. Now for the D option, what do you see? If you take W as a span of 1, 0, minus 1 and 1, 0, 1, you will get W intersection W2 from this, W intersection W2 as a span of 1, 0, minus 1. So this option is again false, because W intersection W2 must be a span of 0, 1, 1. So this option is actually false. Now come back to the option number A. So in the option number A, if you take your W as 0, 1, minus 1 and 0, 1, 1. Okay. Now, what is the intersection between W and W2? So you see the intersection of W2 is actually 0, 1, 1. So now you cannot discard. Okay. So A option might be correct. Now come back to the option number C. So in the option number C, what you are getting, if you take your W as this, what you will get, your W intersection W2 is 0, 1, 1. So these are the two possible answers. Okay, you cannot discard it from the condition number A. So now you have A and C as your answer. Okay, you have to choose among A and C. So B and D are false. You get it. Now you have to choose from A and C. Okay. Now the use of condition one ends here. Okay. Now for the condition number two. Condition number two says that intersection of W and W1 is orthogonal to W and W2. Intersection of W, that means W intersection W1 is orthogonal to W intersection W2. So you see, if you take C as your answer, okay, suppose C is your answer, then W will be 1 0 minus 1 and 0 1 1. Now see, W intersection W1, what is W intersection W1? W intersection W1 is 1 0 minus 1. Okay, and what is W intersection W2? It's 0 1 1. Now they are saying that W intersection W1 is orthogonal to W intersection W2. So you are they are saying that every vector inside W intersection W2 is actually orthogonal to W intersection W2. That means the basis vector, so this vector is actually a basis vector which is spanning W intersection W2, and this vector is again a basis vector which is spanning W intersection W2. So if the space W intersection W1 is orthogonal to W intersection W2, then it will directly imply that the basis vector must be orthogonal. Okay, if basis vector are not orthogonal, then there is no point of saying that W intersection W1 is orthogonal to W intersection W2. So check the orthogonality of those two vectors. Okay, so you see that W intersection W1 is generated by 1 0 minus 1, and W intersection W2 is generated by 0 1 1. So in order to say that they are orthogonal, you need to say that their basis vector must be orthogonal. So just product them. So what you will get? You will get 1.0. Okay, just use the dot product. Okay, generally used in the vector calculus, just use that product. Okay, the usual inner product is the usual inner product on real spaces are actually dot products. So you will get 1.0 plus 0.1 plus minus 1.1. So what you are getting? You are getting minus 1 is your answer. And you know, two vectors are orthogonal if and only if their dot product is 0. So their dot product is not 0. That means that your vector 1 0 minus 1 is not perpendicular to 0 1 1. So from here you can say that the space, if you choose W as this, then your W intersection W2 is not orthogonal to W intersection W2. So your C option is also false. Okay, so the correct one is A. You can directly check it. Okay, check what is for the A option. Check what is W intersection W1. You will get W intersection W1 is actually this. Okay, span of this. What is W intersection W2? It's a span of 0, 1, 1. Now, product these two vectors. 0, 1, 1. What you are getting? You are getting minus 1 plus 1. That is actually 0. So, the space W intersection W1 is orthogonal to W intersection W2. Okay, so it's a very important and easy question from the part linear algebra. So, A answer is correct and every other option is false. Okay, thank you guys.